I'm gonna put that in the video.
No, you're not. I have an intro.
You have an intro?
I'll play your game. Play. Hello, everybody. Welcome to We're Fucking Playing a Game. Give me a kiss. And this is gonna be great for everybody. Fallout 2. Done by Mark and Jess.
What an intro.
Yep.
Wow. Alright, it's movie time.
Give me a kiss before you leave me. It's 2:30 a.m. and we're gonna learn about leaving the vault.
I'm excited. I'm very excited.
Be sure to remember the basic rules. Number one, what?
I'm so excited.
Line up in an orderly fashion.
Oh god, we spent so long trying to get the recordings to work and...
Rule number two. Use protective eyewear when viewing the computer screen for hours on end to try and get the audio and video lined up. Years of living in the vault can make the eyes sensitive to natural sunlight. A phenomenon I am very, very aware of. Without protective eyewear,
your eyeballs. Yeah, I just spent the last 2 hours straight.
Fall out, very close to what I'm feeling right now. Once outside the vault, be prepared for life anew.
Are you ready for life anew?
Geckos.
Don't get me started on geckos in this game.
Lizards are really wonderful.
So, Jess hasn't played this. She's seen just the intro movies, and she tried playing a little bit. Like, the first 10 minutes, she died to scorpions in the first room. Ah! It's movie time.
I vaguely remember an old woman.
Right, the first time you saw this, you were like, wow, this is a lot more grim and dark than Fallout 4, which is what she's been playing.
Right, yeah. Oh, God. I don't like that guy.
Yeah, you're not supposed to like the Enclave.
Who's the...
Probably just a family.
Oh,
a family coming out of the vault.
Children exist.
Yeah.
Changes. That's a thing.
The end of the world occurred pretty much as we had predicted.
There's children.
Too many humans, not enough space or resources to go around. The details are trivial and pointless. The reasons, as always, purely human ones. The Earth was nearly wiped clean of life. A great cleansing. An atomic spark struck by human hands quickly raged out of control. Spears of nuclear fire rained from the skies. Continents were swallowed in flames and fell beneath the boiling oceans. Humanity was almost extinguished, their spirits becoming part of the background radiation that blanketed the Earth. A quiet darkness fell across the planet, lasting many years. Few survived the devastation. Some had been fortunate enough to reach safety, taking shelter in great underground vaults. When the great darkness passed, these vaults opened, and their inhabitants emerged to begin their lives again. One of the northern tribes claims they are descended from one such vault. They hold that their founder and ancestor, one known as the Vault Dweller, once saved the world from a great evil. According to their legend, this evil arose in the far south. It corrupted all it touched, twisting men inside, turning them into beasts. Only through the bravery of this Vault Dweller was the evil destroyed. But in so doing, he lost many of his friends and suffered greatly, sacrificing much of himself to save the world.
Yeah.
When at last he returned to the home he had fought so hard to protect, he was cast out, exiled. In confronting that which they feared, he had become something else in their eyes, and no longer their champion. Forsaken by his people, he strode into the wasteland. He traveled far to the north, until he came Great Canyons. There he founded a small village, Arroyo, where he lived out the rest of his years. And so, for a generation since its founding, Arroyo has lived in peace, its canyons sheltering it from the outside world. It is home. Your home. But the scars left by the war have not yet healed, and the Earth has not forgotten.
Yeah, that's pretty grim.
So if you didn't catch that, the character you play as in the first game, mm-hmm. you basically save the world, and then your own vault, your old home, doesn't want to take you back.
Why?
Because you've changed so much.
Oh, right.
Yeah. All right, I'm gonna set the character up. Should we go through all this, Jess?
What do you mean? No. Just click the buttons. Right. You know what buttons you need, Mark. Just click them. Oh my god!
What?
Nothing. This is just very you.
I'm playing the game.
Put all of your stats into one or two things.
Pillow!
Here she goes.
There she goes.
Come oh, in, chosen
oh, one. This bitch with the ball.
There are things you must know. The village is dying. The signs are everywhere. Withering crops. Dying Brahmin.
God, that's so creepy. Children.
Weird aliens. That's a problem.
There is hope, however. A slim hope. That few know of. The old discs speak of an item called the Garden of Eden Creation Kit. It is said it can bring life to the wasteland.
You look like that sometimes.
What? Wow. Thanks,
this
Mark.
Will be your quest.
You.
If you prove yourself worthy. For that proof, you must first journey to the Temple of Trials.
Oh,
if you
God.
Survive, come back to me.
I'm having flashbacks.
We will talk more. Our life is in your hands,
chosen
one.
Stop!
Find the Gek. Be our salvation.
Bitch, why can't you do it yourself?
She's old. She's an old ass bitch.
Well, I'm tired too. Wow, here we go. Do you have your spear in your hand?
Oh, no.
Oh, it's begun.
I'm gonna use my awesome strategy. Oh, I killed him in one shot. There's no way you can come and hit me. Ah, yes. Oh, this is just what I wanted. 15%.
He looks unhurt.
Bullshit.
He still looks wounded, and you still missed, and severely wounded,
wow.
And God, Jesus, which one of these? Ah, there we go.
Okay. Alright, I'm gonna use some of my skills. Doctor.
This is how you doctor skill. You squat, and you do a little, do a little mumba. There you go. Here's something neat. You do the same motions while opening a door as you do when healing
your wounds.
Yes. Mild to moderate wounds. You missed. Nobody saw that coming.
Got him. I'm doing much better than you were.
Yeah. Yep.
You just wanted to punch the ants.
Yep.
Come on, notice me. Notice me. Notice me sometime. I'm killing it. I'm killing ants. That's what I'm doing. So you gotta anticipate how far they can move. But the problem with that is sometimes they can move much further than you thought. Oh, I crouched. Different animation.
Nice.
Yes!
A hat?
Do you know what this is? It's not a hat. Healing powder.
Healing powder. Oh, okay.
Why am I spinning so fast? Calm
Zoom.
Down. I think there's a way you can highlight stuff. Ooh, I have a map. I don't think I ever knew that there was a map. I think I may have played the whole game the first time without a map.
If you have to punch the scorpion to death, I'm gonna laugh at you.
We might as well save. Oh no, it's just... Wait, these are all my old saves! What the fuck? How do I have all these old saves? Alright, I'm saving over one of them. Weird. Wait, how? No, hang on.
Are they your old saves?
Those are my old saves, I think.
T's?
I think.
Who's T's? You're about to get fucked up.
Unless I'm so good at kiting.
Fuck it.
The brain. Did I see that? The brain?
Brain?
Kill him right in the brain. See, I can just kite him around this thing forever.
I was just about to say, at some point...
I'm gonna misclick?
You're gonna misclick.
Save.
T's 2. T's 3. T's 5.
It was just my character's name.
T's 7. Snap kick his head off.
I was fighting a dude, I remember. God, the memories.
Search the bones.
Hey, another spear.
Neat.
What the?
What is that? Plastic explosive. Is there any chance of that going off in your pocket? Because
no,
you're...
it won't. Okay.
So does this go any faster? Like, do people die faster later on because you can actually hit them?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hello. Ow. Why? What do you think the ant likes? What do you think he enjoys in life?
Nectar.
Do you imagine?
And, stepping on smaller ants.
Oh, wait, I don't know if I have my other spear. Where's my other spear? Oh, wait, I threw it somewhere.
Did you throw it at the scorpions that you dragged
over?
Fuck,
I'm never gonna find it. Oh, I found it! Yes! Grr! Yes! That looked awesome!
There we go!
That was totally worth it. It was worth everything. Oh, God, I gotta use C4. How do I use it? I totally forget.
You're gonna end up blowing yourself up.
Ha! Ah, set the timer! Oh, how close do I want to play this?
Don't.
20 seconds, 20 seconds.
Be normal for 2 seconds and just...
20 seconds? 30
yes.
seconds.
Yes, okay.
Okay, because remember, this is based on your trap skill. How close to the time you set it, how close to that it'll explode. 30. Okay, go. Run! Ah!
What?
Why?
Why did you blow up?
Oh, God. Doomed. What? Starvation. Do I have to place... I have to place it on the ground, I think.
What do you mean you didn't place it on the ground?
I think I just set it while it was in my pocket.
Is there any chance of that going off in your pocket because...
No.
No, that just picks it up. That just picks it up.
I didn't set it. Okay, set it for like 30 seconds and then make sure it's out of your pocket.
Oh, and then I have to drop it. Oh. Is that what this... Okay. All right, set it. Drop. Okay, done. Run. Oh, it's there on the ground. Holy crap. Yeah!
Woo! Hey, kitty. Mama.
Fuck you. Are you starting to feel it? You starting to feel it? Because you didn't like the game at first. Immersed?
No.
Greetings, Pillow.
Wow.
I have the honor of being your final challenge. To continue in your quest, you must defeat me in unarmed combat. Shall we begin?
You say that we are to fight unarmed?
Yes, weapons tend to distance us from battle and desensitize the effects of our actions against others. When you strike another human being with your bare fist, you both see and feel the pain you cause. Battle becomes very personal and all too real then. This is an important lesson for you, Pillow.
Okay.
We gotta fight unarmed. Oh! He took all my equipment. Like, everything? Wait. Oh, I can't snap kick.
Snap kick his head off.
The head! The eyes. Wait, how can I kick eyes? Oh, I killed it! I got him!
Where's he running?
He's unlocking the door for me.
Alright, good. Don't take the things. Actually, he's gotta run all the way out the front.
He's just leaving.
Bye, dude.
I didn't think I did that good, Anna. Well, that's it. Oh. Ta-da!
Oh, is that the Vault Dweller's shit?
Yep. The original Vault Dweller.
And that's in the temple.
First game, first Vault Dweller.
That's in the temple, though.
Yeah, okay. That's in the temple. That's what I just collected. Look what I got on.
You got his shit?
I'm wearing a vault suit.
Whoa!
And I leveled up. Oh, and now I have karma and kills. I've killed 12 ants, 9 scorpions.
Is that all we've done in an hour?
Yes. Look, I have 12 skill points, though. Well, I'm going to save them, because I always do this in games, is I save my skill points until I find a weapon or something that I can use.
Okay.
That's an hour. All right.
Thank you for watching Mark and Jesse playing fucking things and doing great stuff. I'm so tired. I'm leaving.